distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, thank you very much for having me here. It's a pleasure to be in this, especially to participate. The opening yesterday was a very great day for me. Just one thing, from yesterday I had to check. I was very worried after yesterday, and I called my mother. She told me that she loves me. So she said, why are you asking me? She said, don't worry. That was from a conference. She said, okay. But anyway, she loves me. Good. For an Italian, it's important. I hope you check it out as well. So now we have three persons talking about Daesh and one talking about what the coalition is doing. So probably this is what's happening at the moment around the world. Let's start from General Petraeus. I have to thank Pascal. Yesterday, she talked about background, what happened before, root causes. It was in a panel that was mainly focused on Russia, but it very much talked about root causes. Daesh did not start just not bloom like a flower in the spring. So there have been history in the past, and Rafael talk about that. But let's, General Petraeus, so it's not me saying that, he said that US made mistakes in Iraq. We all know that, probably. We participate to that mistakes. We joined that coalition. So it's not only the US that made that mistakes. I think we all did. And the Sunni were probably the victims. Before, we blamed the Sunni for many things, and their leader. But I think the worst mistake was to remove the armed forces and the police. So it was a country left without the forces, the stable forces. I think probably removing a dictator was the right thing. Removing what was keeping the state together was a mistake. And that was even worse because that people, well-trained people, well-equipped, passed to the wrong side. So from being protecting the country or keeping the country together, passed to the other side, fighting against whoever was doing. Then the Maliki government, then the prime minister, he really put a big effort in destroying whatever we tried to do that. And I think you all know what happened there. And the Sunni were, again, the victims of that government. They were excluded from everything, from especially from the resources, from the oil resources. Now, we have a global coalition. We have a global coalition to defeat Daesh. And this global coalition, it takes a lot of states, a lot of efforts from different countries. It's not easy to have that working, but we're doing. And what is very important, if we take some lesson learned from what we heard this morning about Afghanistan, we, from the beginning, as a coalition, we started in training, equipping, and having the Iraqi, in Syria it's a little bit different, to do that fight. We are empowering them to do it. So we are not making the same mistake. We've been much quicker to do ourselves, probably, but that would not last. So very important what we're doing. Role of Iran, we can discuss long, but we have also some ties as an ally, but also we are afraid of what it's doing. So, but Iran is fighting at the moment, and they are losing lives in Iraq as well. But we don't want too much influence about that, and our regional partners don't want. I could close now, that probably it's a summary of whatever we're doing, but you have to listen some more light. So propaganda disinformation. Probably you all heard about the US is supporting Daesh. I think on the internet, that's circulating, but sometimes people don't check it out, disinformation. There are propaganda from some countries, and there are disinformation that's spread around. And after, if we have time, I can tell a story that happened to me last summer during my holidays. So now what we have? We have a whole of government effort. If you see here, we have Daesh. We talked about this. It's an organization. It's a terrorist group. Looking back at the 6th century with modern technology, so 6th century with the latest technology that we are find difficult to fight. And then we have the global coalition. We have this whole of government. This us. Even that picture can be taken here. We're talking about that. We are doing action. We're not just talking about that. So what happened last year, sorry, I need some water. What happened last year, what General Allen was appointed as special envoy for President Obama, and he's, let's say, the coordinator, the leader of this global coalition will participate. And the global coalition, what he say, if you see about what he's saying, basically, is pointing out the role that we all have to play. So we have to remain united to defeat Daesh, but not only Daesh, because that's one group of terrorists. It's not enough. We get rid of Daesh, and we fight on Al-Qaeda before, and we have others. So that's important. It's important to lay the foundation for a stable Middle East. It's very important. And it's a long-term effort. So it's not the focus, it's only Daesh, it's that stabilization. It's avoiding another Maliki government or series of that. And Egypt risked very much after the so-called Arab Spring to have some sort of government that's really based on Sharia law. You had the risk of having a country following not the methods of Daesh, but the same ideology through the Muslim Brotherhood. So we need a better future. What happened last year, September 2014, 63 partners, nation, organization joined together. So it's not only Daesh, we are all of us. Yesterday, I think the Italian ambassador pointed out how important is that we do this effort together, how important is a coalition answer to that. Now, what we have here, it's a long-term strategy, it's not short. We have to be engaged here, but we have to stay there. But there are five lines of effort. And it's in all these lines of effort, there are people working, group of people, different organizations, and military, foreign terrorist fighters, financing and funding. The UN only in January this year declared the Daesh a terroristic organization. From that moment, you can challenge that. You can intervene. You can freeze their funding. Until January, it was not possible legally to do any action against the amount of money that Daesh was moving. So humanitarian relief and crisis, not only in the country, so displaced person around the country, Jordan is very heavily affected, Turkey is affected, Lebanon, but now we see all over Europe. We see yesterday the UK, the German, France, and UK were discussing about what to do with the influx of refugees. Italy, every day we face that. But a country like Serbia, Hungary, so you see what's going on. A lot of this is an impact on what we're doing. So, and then the last one is exposing Daesh, the true nature. So what we do normally, and it's a role also for this COE year, and it's glad because you started already to work that. So it's a NATO already involved, although NATO is not leading the mission, it's US lead, but you see there's already people working on that within NATO. So there are ministerial meetings chaired by the US Secretary of State, so John Kerry is chairing this meeting and pushing all the states. So telling everybody you have a role to play. So each single state, each single organization has a role to play. It's not somebody that we could say, it's not my business. It's a business of everybody. It's a business of everybody because of also this. It's a business of everybody because there are foreign fighters in Iraq and Syria coming from all over the world. Finland is very close to you here, 70 foreign fighters, or well, if this figure are correct, coming even from Finland. And these people are also going back, not all of them, some of them have been neutralized while fighting there. I think that's something good news sometime. But it's very dangerous what they bring back, also going back from that country to our country. And that was important because many countries had no legislation, no possibility for the judiciary to intervene, to do something. And then you say, I'm traveling, I'm a tourist, I'm going to Iraq. What? I cannot do it? Yes. Now there are laws, even in my country, I passed the US, Australia, different countries passed different legislation to give a weapon to the judiciary to intervene, to stop foreign fighters, to have the possibility to challenge them. See, why are you doing that? And that's very important in this fight. We have jihadists. There is something that we discussed about before, but there are, in Great Britain, there are more British Muslims that have joined Islamic State, the Islamic militant groups than the armed forces. This is worrying. It's in within our states, and it's only Great Britain. It's all over, France, Italy, everywhere. But we have the radicalization of Islam in the West. We have a person like this that many of you would recognize his face that had the possibility to speak. Like I'm speaking here, he was speaking in London. He had people listening to him. He had people going from what he was saying to doing terrorist attack all over the world. good enough, he's in jail now, but it was too late probably. What we have now, we have some initiative, and I will use US Department of State. So the Dubai Regional Media Hub, it's very active. It's talking directly to the media in the Middle East. It's very important to have the voice heard directly, because sometimes our regional partners are complaining. What's happening there? Why are you not talking? Why there is a propaganda saying that you are supporting Daesh? And so it's very important. We talk directly. This is a very important initiative. So here we have something about, they have a team, but we have to counter there. Sometimes we are always countering, we should be leading. But Daesh is remaining and expanding. You know how important it's a territory for the caliphate, how important it's to destroy the border between Iraq and Syria, thank you. And that's very important because we build that border according to them, and well, it's true, the reality. But there are defeat on the field. You have Kobani, you have Tikrit. Tikrit, when that was happening, I was there. I was in Kuwait in the coalition. But on Daesh information was, we are winning in Tikrit. I say, that's sick, but we are winning. But the people were listening, so somebody was reading, so it was like it was not happening. Well, got enough, the result, the reality was that was happening, and we were winning. Now Tikrit is in the end of the Iraqi. It's important what they will do. Women and Daesh. Daesh is saying, oh, we are defending women's honor according to the Quran, to the Sharia law, and some Islamic important regulations. But that's hypocrisy. You have to expose that. They are executing women. They are raping women. They are putting women as a secondary class citizen. And this is happening. We have to expose that. And it's happening not only there, but if you see, this has changed also in the streets of Kabul, in the streets of other cities, where in the 70s, women could move freely, and now they are not anymore. So you see more people with burqa, with traditional Islamic clothes going around. So there is also another important group, this Stabilization Working Group. The Stabilization Working Group, it's a German UAE-led initiative, and it's very important what the Iraq will do and the UN as the key players. There are 23 countries in support. It's very important, the stabilization. The Iraq is even more important, the reconstruction. So we have to also work with them to do this stabilization and security sector reform, not only reconstruction and money flowing to the country. And one of the first initiatives is the Italian Carabinieri already there training the police. They started after the stabilization working group. But they are training the police to do the work when they liberate the city, to have law and order imposed in the city. We have also a military coalition, so don't worry, I will not explain what that's, because even working there, you don't understand. But it's very complex. But it's working. That's what happened. This coalition, it's composed by many nations, and most of the people are here, most of the country represented, participate to this in Iraq and in Syria with different. So Iraq, it's a big coalition. Syria, it's a smaller coalition. It's more complex. But we have to deal with this complex military battlefield. It's not easy. Yesterday, I said, well, we have to do. It's not enough to do on the social media. That's great. But this is the real world where the people are fighting, killing, gaining territory, and it's very important. But they are losing, they are on the retreat. This is important, this message you have to spread around. They lost 30% of territories. Not easy to retake city like Mosul, 1.5 million. You don't go as a military, you know how difficult it is to do urban fighting. You don't go there just shelling. We have air power, thanks, they don't move anymore freely. They are on the defense. You don't see anymore this large convoy of the Daesh with flags moving around the country. No, they don't do anymore. That belongs to the past, because they will be targeted by our planes. We are supporting with that. We are doing a great effort. 10,000, more than 10,000 Daesh fighters have been neutralized since the beginning of the operation. This is very important. So there is a working group on strategic communication. We have a public affairs, information operation, key leader engagement. But key leader engagement engaging the people around the region, the leaders of this region, not, of course, you don't engage Daesh. We don't have that possibility. And if you engage them, I think probably you do only once. And you have a tribal engagement. So, but also the public diplomacy. We need to synchronize and coordinate the strategic communication. We have a narrative. The narrative, it's not too difficult. I was there during the campaign plane when we did this narrative. We every word was well, I think, taught and discussed among, with the input from the region. We had the Jordanian very active and other people. And we are enabling Iraqi forces to add Daesh. This is important, and reestablish control over the sovereign Iraqi territory. This is the coalition narrative. It's important that it's not a war against Islam. This is important that our leader spread this, and you hear many times saying that. But we can discuss after, violate Islamic teaching. There is some discussion there because Daesh is saying that they don't violate Islamic teaching, but they are following that. But we can have a discussion there. We will defeat Daesh militarily, but then we need an inclusive government. If the government of Iraq and in Syria, God knows what will be the government in Syria, will change. And in Libya, you see what's happening in Libya now, that nothing will change. So we are training them, but what they are missing at the moment is the will to fight. It's not easy to train a guy like that, but he has to do, he has to fight. There are other good guys, good, well-trained, already fighting, but we have to bring this man here and all the others fighting for their country, having the will to fight. We have also, there have been a leaflet drops on Tikrit, but done by the Ministry of Defense. We have this, as I say, diplomatic and military effort needs to be improved. It's not at best at the moment. We have to work more close to each other. Sometimes we don't fully trust each other, and we're working on that. And sometimes the worst propaganda is coming from, this is an internal memo. Unfortunately, this was on the media, on the US, and you see ISIS is winning on social media. And it's written there, say, it's criticizing ourselves. We are a democracy. We are able to criticize to improve. But then the newspaper take this, and you see it's the best advertising for Daesh that they are winning. So the role of the regional partners, very important, has to increase. At the moment, there is not too strong as we would like to have. And this is a last initiative. So if you are, please check the Shawab Center in Dubai was just inaugurated, and they want to challenge. They want to give the right things, the right message. So it's very important if also on Twitter, so check this site and try to get involved to participate. So key takeaway, coalition, we have to remain united. We have not to be divided in this long-term effort. The military defeat will be achieved, but that will be not enough. So, and the regional partners, as we said, need to take a stronger role. It's their region, their area, they have to do. Inclusive government, I will never stop doing that. Inclusive government, it's key. The coalition that supports the stabilization of Iraq and Syria. And at the end, what I really would, my last message, we have to deal globally. We say it's not a war against Islam, but has to be a war. We have to understand what is the radicalization of Islam, integralism, extremism, jihad in our country. Otherwise, we will never solve the problem. Thank you for your attention, and get involved. Be part of this community. Be active against Daesh. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.